Hello, my name is Sachin Chokse, and I'm a Principal Engineering Manager in the Cortana Intelligence team here at Microsoft. And I'm going to be talking about getting started with Cortana Intelligence solution templates in order to build out advanced analytics and AI solutions to help solve real business problems for you. So big data and advanced analytics has a huge potential to drive transformative change for businesses. 90% of business leaders expect big data and analytics to dramatically change how they do their business. They're expecting 5 times improvement in decision-making using advanced analytics, and this is coming from management consulting firms like Bain. They're expecting 6 to 8% productivity gains to result from investments in these kind of endeavors, data and analytics. Now, this is a higher rate of return than other recent technologies have yielded, even when you go back to the computer investment cycle in the 1980s. But only 4% of the firms that actually are using analytics are doing so in a manner that's truly transformative. So with that, I'd like to introduce Cortana Intelligence Solution Templates. It's a way to help you accelerate your paths towards big data and advanced analytics solutions. Cortana Intelligence Solutions really help improve your business processes and increase competitiveness. Now, at the core of it, these include interactive dashboards that help highlight actionable insights from your data, right? So these are pre-built dashboards that are built for that specific business outcome that you're looking to solve for. They're based on proven solution architectures that enable the transformation of your data into insights, based on the Cortana Intelligence Suite, which in itself is a fully managed big data and advanced analytics platform. Now, these solution templates can be deployed and operationalized in minutes, and they deploy this complex big data architecture, which has already been proven with a number of our customers. You can take these architectures after they've been deployed, and you can scale and customize the solution for your specific needs. If you've got an IT organization that's capable of building out the solution yourself, that's great, because we've got these rich technical guides that help you build that enterprise-grade solution yourself. However, let's say you don't have the manpower necessary. We've got a qualified set of partners to help you with proof of concepts in your environments and to drive that operationalization as well as creating of production solutions that are specifically built and custom-tailored for your use case, right? So today we're launching 3 solution templates. There are 2 in the retail space, demand forecasting and personalized offers, and there's 1 in the manufacturing space for quality assurance. Each of these has a set of partners, like I mentioned, already pre-qualified, which you can reach out to, and they're in various time zones. And they're in the EMEA, in the US, Asia Pacific, as well as some global ones. And here's the list, and we'll keep adding more as we qualify more partners. So with that, let me actually jump into a demo of the Quality Assurance for Manufacturing solution template. So this is the Cortana Intelligence Gallery, and this is where you'll find all the Cortana Intelligence solution templates. The gallery is at gallery.cortanaintelligence.com. Now within that, if you come here and click on Solutions, that's where you'll find this full set of solution templates that Microsoft's providing. Now within that, let's go look at the Quality Assurance for Manufacturing solution template like we initially described, right? Now this specific solution template is used for digital manufacturing scenarios where quality assurance across that assembly line is seriously important, right? So you've got a whole set of assembly lines that are being used in sequence or potentially in parallel with the network to build out a specific product, and the different devices that are moving across the assembly line towards the assembly of that final product. Now, as you can probably imagine, identifying errors and slowdowns and potential failures before they occur rather than after can really help companies be more proactive and improve productivity within their assembly line. So if you think about a digital product that's being made and consists of a printed circuit board and one part of the assembly line is applying solder paste to that circuit board. And then the next part is actually putting on the microprocessor. Now, if that solder paste isn't applied correctly, that microprocessor on the second part of that assembly line isn't going to sit on that board correctly. And so identifying that failure in the earlier part of that assembly line and predicting that failure before reacting to it is actually more cost efficient, because a company can essentially reuse that circuit board, they can rewash them and reapply that paste, as opposed to having to just get rid of the product or get rid of the fully assembled circuit board at the end with the microprocessors attached. Or even worse, have a negative customer experience when that product with the circuit board within it comes back for repairs or warranties. So that's a specific scenario that this specific solution template is trying to solve. Let's actually take a look at the kind of dashboard you get with it. So if you click on Try It Now, it essentially opens up a dashboard, a Power BI dashboard. Now, this is a pre-built dashboard. It's built off of some test data from the University of California, Irvine. And this is the CCOM data set. So this is what you're essentially seeing within this dashboard. This is simulating five different assembly lines. And this system is actually predicting the failures of each of those assembly lines, right? And it's specifically predicting the failure of each device as it's coming through, as it's moving through those assembly line. So you can see that assembly line one has a 58% success and a 41% failure rate. And each of the devices, as it's going through those assembly lines, you're predicting whether it's going to fail or pass. And all of this is based off of data that's already coming from the tests and the sensors that are on the assembly line. All you're doing is you're ingesting that data into the system that's part of the solution, and you're using machine learning models that are pre-built into the solution to predict that. As you can see, this specific data set has about 7 hours of data. So if you look at a specific hour, you can pull in sensors or information from specific sensors that you might be interested in, specific dates as well as specific times. So this is the kind of dashboard that you'd get with this solution template. So let's take a look at the underlying architecture of this specific solution. Now, this specific solution, there's real-time data streams coming off of actual assembly line, and the way that data is being generated is using a data generator that's built into the solution. Those data streams are ingested in real-time by the Event Hub and analyzed in real-time by Azure Stream Analytics. Azure Stream Analytics actually calls a machine learning API that's built using Azure Machine Learning, which is predicting if each of the devices based on the test data around that device is going to fail or should be passed along to the rest of the assembly line or the succeeding assembly line. That real-time data along with the test results as well as the prediction is shown in a Power BI dashboard in real time. Historical data is also stored in Azure SQL Data Warehouse for data at rest analysis, and that information from the SQL Data Warehouse can also be shown in that specific Power BI dashboard. And this is the same dashboard that I showed you earlier. Now, a person who's sitting in the field, maybe at the manufacturing line, is going to be keeping an eye on these dashboards and taking a look at those specific predictions and saying, should I be taking this specific device off the line or leaving it on the line? So this is the underlying big data architecture that's built into this solution. So assuming that you want to move forward, you come in here and we've already played with the dashboard and you say, okay, I want to deploy this. You go ahead and click deploy. So once you click deploy, you'll come up to the solution deployment wizard. So I'm going to give my deployment a name. As you can see, I've given it a name already here. I'm going to choose a specific subscription. This is an Azure subscription that I want to deploy into. I'm going to choose a specific location. Let's say I'm going to choose West Europe to deploy here. And I'm going to give it a name and click Create. Now, once I click Create, I'm going to be prompted for a couple more things. I'm going to be asked to provide a username for the SQL Data Warehouse that I'm creating. So let me give it a name and a password. I'm going to click Next. And this is where the entire deployment is now taking place. Now, this deployment takes about 20 to 30 minutes. So let's fast forward through this a little bit. So once the entire deployment is done, I'm going to see a page like this, which is essentially showing me my next steps. Now, this says I've successfully deployed the entire big data solution. And again, this took about 20 to 25 minutes to put down in the specific Azure, in my Azure subscription, right? I'm going to go and look at the resource group that included this specific deployment. Click on that. When I click on that, I essentially get this. So you can see that I deployed into this subscription, into the West Europe region, and these were all the different Azure components that were created and hooked up in this specific architecture as a part of this deployment. Now, in order to finish up, I've got a few more steps. I'm going to go look at the post-deployment instructions, and I've got that deep technical guide that I described earlier. That's where you'll find it. So I'm going to go click here. And that's going to open up the solution how-to guide that comes as a part of every Cortana Intelligence solution. Now, a solution how-to guide is this deep technical guide that you can use to follow along after an automated deployment. Or if you wish, you can actually build out the entire deployment piecemeal using the manual deployment guide that's also included in the solution instructions. So this specifically talks about the dashboard, the underlying architecture, the specific use cases. In this specific one, we actually work with a company called Jabil, which is in the manufacturing space. And there's a case study out there as well, which you could look for, which talks about how Microsoft used advanced analytics to help Jabil improve the efficiency of their manufacturing lines. If you'd like to jump to the post-deployment instructions for the automated deployment guide, that's where you'd come. And you'd look at everything that was essentially deployed. Again, it talks about the architecture, the overall flow, and the post-deployment instructions, which are right here. Where more often than not, the first thing you want to do post-deployment is essentially look at the stuff that was actually deployed, figure out where things went, and then start setting up the visualizations. So this is the final step, is actually setting up the visualizations, where you'd want to hook up the real-time streams that were deployed as a part of your solution with Power BI, and this has all the manual steps that you'd need to do in order to actually finish that up. So once you've finished setting up your Power BI, and the Power BI desktop file, which has the entire dashboard pre-built, is here already. You can just download it. You can finish setting that up, and this is the kind of Power BI dashboard that you'd get at the very end. So again, this is showing those five different assembly lines. There are five different machine learning models that are basically predicting each assembly line and the devices and the failures for each specific device. You can look at there's real-time data coming in. Since I deployed this, there have been about 28,000 events or 28,000 data points that have been ingested. And for assembly line zero, there's roughly 14,000 failures that were predicted. And in the last few minutes, there were about 20 different failures and four passes. So this line isn't doing as great as you can see. And same thing, you can follow through with different assembly lines and set up the same kind of information, as well as you can take action based on the specific predicted failures for each of these devices. Here is the actual machine learning experiment that was deployed as a part of this. And all these resources that are put down, like I said earlier, are visible in the Next Steps page. So you can get to each of those devices and each of those Azure resources that are laid down using this. So the way I got to the machine learning experiment was I clicked on Azure Machine Learning Studio and looked for that specific workspace. So this is that workspace, and these are all the machine learning experiments or the web services that were laid down. Once you have deployed it and everything's working end to end, you can essentially start playing with it and start tweaking it to your specific needs. Now, let's say you don't have the capability to do this yourself, here's a set of predefined partners that we have pre-qualified, and we'll keep adding more to this list where you can actually go and reach out to them and see if they can help you with your specific deployment. All right, so now that you've seen the demo, right? Why Cortana Intelligent Solution Templates, right? They're easy to get started. There's no upfront commitment. As long as you have an Azure account, you can quickly deploy one and get started. You can scale and customize the solution to your needs. It's got the rich technical guides built into it that you can use and follow along. And if you don't want to do it yourself, you've got the partner ecosystem that's already pre-qualified that you can use to extend and to accelerate your time to value. So to get started now, go to aka.ms/CI solutions to find and deploy a whole bunch of different Cortana Intelligence solution templates. Thank you.